got her start. And now she's devoted to art, they call her Rose. On Washington Square, she's withering there. In basement air, they call her Rose. In plain old fancy clothes, they say her Roman nose appeals to those artistic creatures. She's got plenty of those in second-hand clothes and nice long hair. She's got those Broadway vampires lashed in the past. She's got no future, but boy, what a past that's wrong. On Washington Square. Thank you.
Walter Hall, Louis Armstrong. In the middle, we might just do something by Henry Allen or something like that, just to show the other people who were around at the same time as Louis. And there were other people, of course, around at the same time as Red Nichols. And one of them was a trumpet player called Phil Napoleon. So we're going to play something from one of his bands. It's called the Rampart Street Blues. I think the trombone player was Tommy Dorsey, and the clarinet player was the almost sober Jimmy Dorsey. Strange thing about it was that the tune, I'm More Than Satisfied, was written by Thomas Fats Waller. So maybe the only Fats Waller tune the Beats ever played. I wonder whether Fats ever played it down in Port Blues. You never know. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm More Than Satisfied, and if you'd like to take a dance, this is very nice. Also going
thank you.
Stuff this is, it's called Get a Load of This. The glamorous Mike Piggott. here is a tune that Rodgers and Hart wrote especially for Mike way back in 1927. And what is that strange instrument?
It's a strobe violin, which some of you might have seen yesterday. It's an example of a very early recording violin. So, I left the Jack Russell dog at home.
Thank you.
also rewritten with words, called I'll Never Be the Same.
Stick to the improviser. The bass player that I play with occasionally, who calls this the African swine pipe.
Written by Myth Mole, the great trombonist, called Slipping Around. So think of me while I'm playing it. Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you.
Orchestra Cook, many great guests. We'll be back for last. Thank you. Tis recording musicians all the way through the 1920s, and he joined the band in, I think, 26 or 27, by who was led by Roger Wolf Carr. Now, the only comparison is the Russian billionaire who bought Chelsea football team, because Roger Wolf Kahn's dad was Otto Kahn, who was an armaments millionaire, and he said, "Well, son, if you want a jazz orchestra, I'll buy you one." So he actually bought, well, virtually the entire Red Nichols Five Pennies are in the Roger Wolf Kahn orchestra. Unfortunately, as Roger Wolf Kahn had about 27 people in his orchestra, we can't quite recreate it here, but we will do our best. So here's a lovely number that I don't think it's been played in Keswick before. It's probably not been played since 1929, when it was first recorded. It's called "I'm Walking Through Clover." And the clarinetist on it was Benny Goodman.
And trombone player Mike Rogers.
Oh, I see. Oh, that's okay. Right. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. of the afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Bass saxophone, the lowest of the low. Yes. Insulting. Yes. He's playing his York bass saxophone, made in Grand Rapids, Michigan. And the tune we're going to do is Ida, Sweet as Apple Cider. And of course, the reason bass sax is on a lot of these Red Nichols things is that Red Nichols used to book only the finest musicians by Colin Turner. And he's salaried with playing in the style of Adrian Rollini. Would you give us a little bit of shuffle rhythm, please, Thomas?
Thank you.
tune called I'm Tickled Pink with a Blue-Eyed Baby.
Thank you.
haven't noticed, the violin is a curved bridge, so you can normally just play one string or two strings at once, and then two that way. So you can't actually play four strings together. But Joe perfected the art of that, and he called a tune Four String Joe. But we're not going to play that. exactly like you, which will give you a taste of that. I must tell you briefly, I was very fortunate to see Joe Venuti towards the end of his career at the Beauty Jazz Festival, and I caught his set in the afternoon, and he came on stage and he said, I'm going to play a piece by Debussy, and I'm going to play it straight, and then I'm going to hot it up a little bit, and then I'm going to tear it apart. And that's what he did, and we're not going to play that either. This is exactly like you.
Thank you.
Mr. Mike Piggott. Thank you for being so patient with us to play the music of Red Nichols. The chaps did put a lot of work into it. So big hand for the members of the Collegians, Norman Field at the clarinet. At the tuba and double bass saxophone, and well, ladies and gentlemen, what can I say? Colin Turner. The grand jazz percussion kit, merry quips, and all the rest of it. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Nick Ward. Ladies and gentlemen, crooner extraordinaire, banjoist par excellence, and guitarist excrementable. Ladies and gentlemen, Thomas Spats Langham. An absolute rock. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Nick Gill. Today, playing the music of Red Nichols, paying a lot of attention to his style, and also that of Big Spider-Man. Ladies and gentlemen, Andy Woon.
And of course, not forgetting our musical director and Merry Quipster. Mr. Keith Nichols.
So we're going to close with a beautiful number recorded quite a few times by Red Nichols and many other people. There may be a vocal by Thomas.
Oh, don't know about that.
Yes. Especially as I haven't told him what tune we're going to do. It's You're Nobody's Sweetheart Now. Yes, let's have some down the avenue, they can't burn.
your nobody sweetheart now.
Thank you. Good afternoon.